just in case you need something to keep you up at night, we cannot see them directly, but astronomers estimate that our galaxy is peppered with anywhere from 10 million to a billion black holes. They're all remnants of stars whose cores collapsed into infinitesimally small points, and while each is bizarre and brain-bendy in its own way, models tell us that these objects at least have limits. But then again, our models are sometimes wrong. Like, picture a star with a composition similar to the Sun's, but much bigger. According to models, the biggest black hole made from a single star like that couldn't exceed 25 solar masses. Except, astronomers have just found one weighing in at more than twice that. They published their mystery last week in the journal Nature, and it might require rethinking exactly how massive stars evolve. This black hole was found while astronomers were looking at data from a star about 8 times more massive than the Sun. It's called LB1, and the paper's authors calculated that it's roughly 14,000 light-years away. Based on patterns in the star's light, they found that it was moving, getting closer to and then farther away from Earth over a period of about 79 Earth days. That indicated that it was orbiting something, something the team couldn't detect. Still, even though they couldn't see the mystery object, they could use data from LB1 to estimate its mass, and the results were pretty telling. Based on the calculations, the smallest possible mass for this object, just based on how the star was moving, was about 6 solar masses. Technically, that means it could be a star, but a star that massive would be bright enough for us to detect it. So instead, the team proposed that this companion had to be a black hole. After analyzing more data, they estimated that the actual mass of this thing is between 55 and 79 times the mass of our Sun. And this is where things get messy, because those numbers are more than twice the mass we thought possible given the black hole's surroundings. See, both LB1 and the surrounding area contain a decent amount of elements other than hydrogen and helium. And according to models, single stars can't form huge black holes in that kind of environment. They should lose too much material at the end of their lives, so if they do become black holes, they should peak around 25 solar masses, not 55 to 79. So this discovery might mean we need to go back and modify our models of how stars evolve. But it may also mean that something else is going on. For instance, the authors of this paper have suggested that, well, maybe LB1's black hole didn't come from a single star after all. Maybe the system used to have 3 stars, but after one collapsed into a black hole, it ate one of the remaining 2. Alternatively, maybe there are 2 less massive black holes here, and they're orbiting each other so closely that we can't tell them apart. Of course, it may also turn out that the distance measurements of LB1 are incorrect, since some of the team's data do disagree with other sources, and that would seriously mess up the math here. But regardless of how that plays out, this black hole will still be special. Right now, it's the only stellar mass black hole we've found that can't be observed in the X-ray part of the electromagnetic spectrum. That means it's not stealing gas off its companion star, and it's not actively consuming matter. So this discovery could mean that there is an entire population of these secret black hole companions just waiting to be found. In other black hole news, a group of astronomers published a paper last week in the Astrophysical Journal with evidence that planets, could apparently form around supermassive black holes. And I don't mean like the black hole's gravity captured them, I mean planets could form around black holes the way they do around stars. Just when you think you understand the universe, black holes once again show up and ruin everything. It does give me context, though. I'm glad that our planet is orbiting not a black hole. According to the paper, the action happens in what's called the circumnuclear disk. This is a thin disk of dust and gas that's a ways away from the black hole, much farther than the accretion disk that feeds the thing. Out there, the black hole's gravity isn't overpowering, so particles could collect into a giant ball of rock. But if you're gonna make a planet around a black hole, you don't just need distance. Your circumnuclear disk also needs to be dense, partly partly because, well, like, you need a lot of stuff to make a planet, but also because you need something to block radiation from the accretion disk. Otherwise, the outer region of the circumnuclear disk will be too hot, and grains of ice and dust won't be able to stay solid and bind together. In theory, black holes should be able to check these boxes no problem, but in the new paper, one team decided to actually test it. They applied current models for planetary formation to the circumnuclear disk of a supermassive black hole that was actively eating matter, and their model generated 85,000 planets, each about 10 times the mass of Earth and orbiting at various distances. Admittedly, this planet-making process didn't happen quite like normal. Among other things, the planets took about 400 million years to form, which is several times longer than what happened in our solar system. But hey, like, they formed around a supermassive black hole, it makes sense that things would happen a little differently. These results are amazing to think about, but they only came from a model. We're still a long way away from finding planets like this, if they're really out there. After all, it was only this year that we managed to image the shadow of a supermassive black hole. Finding a planet amongst all of that will be way more difficult. The authors actually point out that the usual methods for finding planets are, in this case, and I quote, hopeless. But there could maybe possibly be something in X-ray or radio wave data. Still, when you think about it, it wasn't long ago that it was impossible to detect any planets around other stars. So who knows what we will be capable of in the future. Thanks for watching this episode of SciShow Space News. Before you go, we've got two quick announcements for you. First, this episode was brought to you by our president of space, SR Foxley. SR is one of our patrons on Patreon and is part of the community that keeps SciShow going, so thank you for your support. And also, it's December, which means it's calendar shopping time. And if you're in the market for a 2020 calendar, consider checking out a thing that we made, our lunar calendar. It's very satisfying to look at, and it displays the phase of the moon for every day of the year, so you can always be informed about what's going on up there. You can find them at a link below or at dftba.com.